So by now you're quite familiar with the singular value decomposition, and now we're going to look at it slightly differently. What are we going to do? Well, in this course we like to slice and dice. What does that mean? We like to think in terms of regions of matrices as opposed to in terms of individual entries or even individual columns. How does that apply here? Well, what if sigma r minus 1 is the first non-zero entry on the diagonal of sigma? In other words, we have r non-zero singular values. Then, if we partition the diagonal matrix like this, this allows us to nicely capture a true diagonal matrix, that's r by r, square, a bunch of regions that have zeros in them, and then correspondingly, we could partition our matrix U into the first r columns, and then the rest of them, and we can partition our matrix V into the first r columns, and then the rest of them. And then we could label these. We could call this here U left, the left part of the partitioned matrix U, U right, V left, and V right. And then we could call this region here sigma top left, where we have top left, top right, bottom left, bottom right. So what that means is that we can view our singular value decomposition as U left, U right, times the matrix with the top left exposed and zeros for the rest. And then the matrix V left, V right, which must be transposed. Now, if you multiply this out, what do you get? Okay. Well, this times this gives you U left times sigma top left plus this U right times zero. So we get U left times sigma top left for the left part. And then U left times zero plus U right times zero gives you a nice block of zeros. And then if we Hermitian transpose this partitioned matrix right here, we get V left Hermitian transpose, V right Hermitian transpose. And if we now multiply this out, we get this times that plus this times that. And therefore we get U left times sigma top left times V left Hermitian transpose. Okay? Now, if we go back to exposing the individual columns and the diagonal, then we get that this is U0 through UR minus 1 times the diagonal matrix sigma 0 through sigma R minus 1 times the matrix partitioned by columns V0 through VR minus 1 Hermitian transpose. And one thing you notice is that it should take less to store this than it would to store the entire singular value decomposition. All right. Now, we can go one step further and then notice that this here is just the matrix sigma 0 times U0 through sigma r minus 1 through u r minus 1, and let's put some bars in here so we know that these are columns of the matrix, times the matrix v0 Hermitian through vr minus 1 Hermitian transpose. And if you multiply that out, you get the first column times the first row plus the second column times the second row and so forth. So you get sigma 0 u0 V0 Hermitian transpose plus sigma 1 U1 V1 Hermitian transpose and so forth. Sigma R minus 1 U R minus 1 V R minus 1 Hermitian transpose. And what are each of these? Well, each of these is a scalar times an outer product. So this we can depict as a scalar times an outer product plus a scalar times an outer product, and so forth. And sometimes you will want to reason about the singular value decomposition. Sometimes you will want to use this formulation, which is known as the reduced singular value decomposition. And sometimes you will want to look at it as the sum of outer products of rank one matrices. Remember that a matrix has rank at most, an outer product has a rank at most one. Here we know that the vectors involved are of length one, so definitely each of these outer products is of rank one. And then if you scale those by non-zero scalars, then you end up with terms that each are of rank one. Anyway, in different circumstances, viewing the same thing in a slightly different way will give you some advantages. And as you play with the singular value decomposition, you'll gain experience with when to use what formulation.